What does it mean to be bonkers for Jesus?
What does it mean? It means to be sold out for Jesus. For me, it means every day that I wake up with one mission in mind, and that's to hear at the conclusion of my day, well done, my good and faithful servant. I try to listen to the Lord. I wake up in prayer. I go to bed in prayer. Prayer dictates every area of my life. And it's helped me be a better father. It's helped me be a better husband. It's helped me be a better friend. It's helped me be a better employer. To be sold out and to be bonkers for Jesus is indescribable. It's an awesome experience. It's a life choice.
Are you bonkers for Jesus and why?
Well, I'm bonkers, period. Okay, anybody that knows me knows I'm bonkers. So, of course, I'm bonkers for Jesus. Why not be bonkers for Jesus, right? And he was bonkers for me when he went to the cross. And so that's why I'm bonkers for him.
Is there anything else you would like to tell us today?
I think the biggest impact in my life was to fully understand that God loves me. For a lot of years, I thought it was about doing and what I didn't do and what I do. And then I really learned it's about what he did and what he does through me. I just love him. So I just love to talk about God's love and how it flows through me to others. And I don't have to work at it. I just let it flow through.
Thank
you. Are you bonkers for Jesus or what?
Yes, I am, because he changed my life. I accepted Christ when I was 12 years old. And it made a tremendous difference in the way I lived. And I've seen his blessing in my life for many, many years. And I always applaud the people who have good testimonies, you know. They did drugs and the Lord delivered them. Or they went to jail and the Lord delivered them. But I'm thankful that he kept me from all that stuff. And I've had a great life and it's just getting better. And I love what he's done for me. But more importantly, I love what he does for other people.
What was your defining moment in your journey with Christ?
I remember when I was about 8 years old, I was at a camp, and I realized that I needed help to get through life. And someone explained to me about Jesus Christ being my friend and giving me strength, supernatural strength. And ever since that time, I've been learning to be the person that God wants me to be with the Spirit of God inside of me.
Is there anything else you'd like to share with us?
I think God loves everybody, and I think God gives us strength beyond imagination. He lets us rise up like wings with eagles and fly and soar and do things that are supernatural, and I like being supernatural.
What was your defining moment in your journey?
For Christ?
For Christ.
Yes. I had various examples of God taking care of me. You know, if you listen to that small, still voice, he's always giving you guidance and direction on what to do. You ever been in a situation where something bad happened and you say to yourself, I knew that, I should have done something differently. A small voice told me to do that. That happened to me various times.
Is there anything else you would like to share with us today?
I love the Lord very, very much. And I hope to plant a seed in young people so they can recognize and understand and have that foundation in their lives so they can love the Lord as well.
Are you bonkers for Jesus and why?
I'm bonkers for Jesus because I found out that the reason why God sent his only begotten Son is to redeem me and bring me back in the right standing with him because of what happened in the Garden of Eden. When Adam disobeyed God. I've come into that knowledge and I accept that, and that's why I'm what I am today.
And are you bonkers for Jesus and why?
Yes, I'm bonkers for Jesus. What's that mean? Bonkers for Jesus. Crazy?
Kinda.
Yeah, I'm crazy for Jesus. Why? When I was younger, I was not. I believed in church because we had to go. But didn't understand who Jesus was. And so I went to church, and then I kind of went away from church for a long time and discovered firsthand that God is real. My mother had terminal cancer. She was diagnosed to be dead at 3 months. That was in 1986. She's alive today. The doctor said that there was no hope, there was nothing medically they could do, so we just had God in prayer. And something changed, and that kind of made me pay attention to maybe God is real. And ever since then, pa-da.
This week I learned how to zoom in and zoom out on a camera, and I learned a new dance in dance class.
This weekend I went to Bonkers for Jesus, and I learned how to interview people and work the camera. Make sure it's level when you're interviewing someone, and also make sure the background's good, and also make sure you can hear them nice and clear. And I made lots of friends, and I learned some new moves in dance class.
This week's in Bonkers for Jesus, I learned how to give orders through a headset.
This week for Bonkers for Jesus, I learned how to use control buttons for to fade to black and camera 1, 2, and 3.
This week at Bonkers for Jesus, I learned how to be Bonkers for Jesus and make new friends and do dance at dance class.
My favorite part of this week is learning how to play golf and be like Tiger Woods.
My favorite part this week was interviewing people.
My favorite part about Bonkers for Jesus was meeting my amazing class of video production.
My favorite part about Bonkers for Jesus was meeting Miss Olivia.
My favorite part about Bonkers for Jesus was meeting her, Miss Olivia.
We are fine!